landed, that's when I met Petrus and Bob and the other guys along the way. So it took us 3 or 4 albums until we became a more solid, real band, not just like a studio project. Yeah, it's great. I mean, we took a break for a few years, and when we did Immortals, we didn't know what was out there for us 5 years later. And we set out to do this European tour, and we said, okay, let's do this, and maybe a couple of festivals, and we'll see how it goes. But then the record got really great response worldwide, and we kept getting offers all the time, so we kept adding shows and adding, and we went to Russia for the first time, and we started doing a lot of festivals and going to, you know, did an extensive tour in Spain, and then we toured again with Rage, and then this offer came up, we were invited to Latin America, and this is something we've wanted for many years. So.
And it's your first time here, right?
Yeah, first time
here. Are you excited?
Yeah, very excited.
Interesting thing in this story is all these years when we announce a tour in Europe, we announce a Greek show, everybody, every time we get these messages, come to Mexico, come to Argentina, come to Brazil. So now, finally we're here. Let's see what happens.
Especially come to Chile.
Chile,
that's
yes.
That's the most popular one. Probably nobody's going to show up.
And then Venezuela, by the way.
Probably nobody's going to show up.
Yeah. And we were disappointed all this year.
Yeah, exactly. So, who's next?
Hello, good afternoon. Welcome to Mexico City. First of all, what do you expect about the Mexican fans here for 5 weeks?
Well, you know, we've heard great stories from friends of ours in other bands that have been touring here for years, and they told us the best things, that the crowds are really crazy here, and they are really wild crowds. And I mean, honestly, since it's the first time, and I always do that, at least for myself, I think to myself, I always expect, I don't have high expectations, I always don't expect much out of it, and if it goes well, then even better. So, I mean, just the fact that we made it, it's great. Yeah.
And in another hand, another question. Yesterday arrived your new CD, Corcucci.
It's coming out in April.
That's the following question. When is going to be the release?
It's April 20th, comes out.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
Can you tell us about your musical philosophy of the band?
That's a good question. We just like to play music that comes from our hearts, basically. Usually our songs have we're all positive people, and we like to spread a positive message through our songs. In the earlier years, we used to write some stuff about like fantasy lyrics and stuff, but usually our lyrics deal with human condition and emotions. And I mean, the last album we did is a first concept record, and it's about Greek history, because three of us in the band are from Greece, and it's an open idea that we had for many years. So we deal with various topics, but this is the music we like to play. We've always done that. We've always stuck to our guns like that. As long as there's people out there that are interested in listening to it.
When the times change and the people like other stuff, we stick to what we're doing, and maybe, you know, times are changing and the people, you know, we cannot follow what's happening, just do what we're doing.
Let's play first, and then we will have a better feeling about it. But I think from the little bit that I've seen, and I've met some Mexican fans at like in festivals, or we did a boat at 70 Towns, and they seem to really know what's happening. They know they're heavy metal. They know they really listen, and they're passionate about music. So this is the kind of feeling that I get initially without having played here ever. So. Yeah, I have a good vibe about it.
About the record, this is about the Spartans. So how do you write the lyrics? Do you play games or a battle?
Well, for us, it's not so much as if you're a fan or not. It's more like, this is part of our history. We grew up and we just knew about history, mythology, this stuff you hear about in school. Of course, there's like a lot of Hollywood movies about famous battles like Thermopylae or whatever, you know. So I think it was a lot of our friends and even fans and people from our circle, like close circle, they kept telling us and pushing us about it. Like, you should do something about that. You should, you're a Greek man, you should write something about your history and stuff. And eventually we gave in. We thought we'd give it a try. And, worked out well, and I mean, I think heavy metal music is a good soundtrack for those kind of stories. It goes hand in hand.
And actually, the album is great. Congratulations!
Thank you. So you two only are the ones that are not shy. Everybody else.
Jess Diaz for Metal Union.
You can tell it in Spanish, he knows Spanish.
Oh, it's okay, thank you. Bueno, ¿cómo cada uno de ustedes llegó al rock? ¿Cómo cada uno de ustedes llegó al rock? Al rock.
When I was a teenager, just growing up, listening to music,
what was the first thing? First thing you see?
Megadeth.
I got it. You? As a song, can I play with madness? And that was it.
Okay.
Yes.
For me, actually, it's a little bit more old school way, because my father had some hard rock vinyls at home. No heavy metal then, but he had like Eagles, Hotel California, and Peter Frampton Comes Alive. And I love the sound of the guitar, the solo guitar. And that's how I got exposed to rock. And then later, when I was in high school, some friends gave me like tapes of Black Sabbath and stuff like that. And of course, Metallica, Guns N' Roses was on TV at the time. I'm talking about like early 90s now. A lot of kids, like a lot of guys of our generation, probably were exposed to the same stuff.
Okay.
You?
Back then, we had many vinyls at home, so my father was listening to Judas Priest, Iron Maiden, Accept, all the good stuff. My first vinyl was from the band Heart, Bad Animals. So my first band was at the age of 13, my first rock band. So it came the way.
And I came like traditionally with friends in the first grade, like middle 80s. They put me into, you know, like Iron Maiden stuff and this, and that's it.
That's the only band.
I only listen to
Iron Maiden. Okay.
And some of Firewood stuff.
Yeah, some
of Spanish, please. ¿En qué te basaste para ponerle el nombre a tu banda? Para llegar al nombre de Firewind, ¿en qué se basaron?
How did you come up with the name Firewind?
This is an easy one.
Yeah, easy, yeah. I actually stole it from Uli John Roth. Uli Roth, the guitar player from the Scorpions. When he left the Scorpions, he had a band called Electric Sun. And the second record of that band was called Firewind. And I'm a big fan of Uli's, and very influenced by him, and I love that record, and I always thought that name would be cool for a band name, and I just borrowed it
for a couple of years.
Yeah.
Once again, sorry. I would like to know, for me, one of my inspired songs is Life on Wait. How do you feel about it? Do you remember Life on Wait that you played with Ozzy Osbourne? What was your main inspiration about that song to play with that as well? With that song, every Mexican day, that song saved so many lives.
You did?
Wow. Suicide, drugs, was like huge influence. How do you feel to be a part of it?
It was a big honor to be on that record, you know? Play on his record. Not only on that song, but all of the material. I think that there was a lot of good material, and actually Life on Wait is one of the standout tracks on Scream album, I think. It was also one of my favorites. And it's a funny story, because we were in the studio with the producer, Kevin Turco, and we were going through a lot of the stuff that he had already written for Ozzy, and I was recording guitar parts and stuff. And then he said, I have this, I said, do you have anything else? And he said, I have this song that I'm probably not going to use it. And I said, let me hear it. And it was this. And I heard it, and I said, dude, this song you have to have on the album. So we started working on that and adding real guitar parts. So,
thank you very much.
How was your feeling for being a producer from Ozzy Osbourne?
The last
album.
I mean, it was a once in a lifetime opportunity, you know. It's amazing to just be a part of that history, you know. And, I mean, he's one of the reasons why we all love this music and why we're all here today. So it was just great. I have very
Okay, thank you.
Hi, Gabo Rex from Estrando Metallico and metal band Angel of Metal. Can you tell us about your experience with Ozzy Osbourne?
Yeah, as I just said, it was more or less.
And counting the.
It was a really good experience. For me. It opened up a lot of doors, of course. It gave me a lot of spotlight, and of course, I think it also helped the band as well. And our cause, and it was just I learned a lot being involved. I mean, it is one of the biggest bands in the world. It was great to be a part of it, and I have only good things.
Thanks so much.
We're going to be a limit class later, so how important for you is to keep going with this kind of stuff to teach kids and that kind of thing?
Originally, when I first started doing it, I wasn't into it so much, but as I got a bit more experience by doing clinics, because, you know, it's one of those things that you don't only teach, but you also learn from yourself, because you get to talk to people and you get to interact and you hear their thoughts and you hear what's troubling them and all these questions, they make me think as well. So nowadays, I really appreciate it a lot, and it's something I really look forward to doing whenever there's an opportunity to do a clinic. Of course, there's also the performance part. You know, I try to help younger players if I can, if I have the answers for the things they're looking. But it's also interesting for me to pick their brains and how they think, how people think, and how they feel about music, what it means to them, and those things. So I think it's a double learning experience. Yes,
ma'am. Hello from Iron Castle. Well, next album's coming. When?
Oh,
long wait.
No, we are probably gonna do the next album. Then, I think
end of the next year or something.
What year is it now? 2018.
2019.
I mean, obviously now I'm gonna release a solo record and we're all gonna take a break from Fire and after. We're gonna do a few festivals in the summer and then we're gonna take a little break. We're all gonna go out and do different things, and we're gonna get together in a few months after that. I think within the next year we should start gathering material. Nobody wants to wait that long again, so I think we're gonna do it. If not at the end of 2019, definitely 2020. Yes.
En español, ¿tienen algún acercamiento con el metal mexicano y qué piensan de la escena en México?
Do we know anything about Mexican
metal?
I know the best guitar players
from
Mexico, Carlos Santana.
Ah,
okay.
Yeah. Isn't it? I don't know about metal
bands
from Mexico either.
No. Sorry, no.
Nada, nada.
We love the food.
We
love
tacos.
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 Really?
Hola, ¿qué tal? Mi nombre es Nidia Castro, soy Video Magazine. Quisiera saber cuál es su canción favorita y cuál es la canción que les pide más el público allá en Canadá. No, allá en su país. Gracias.
What's our favorite song? What's the song that in Canada has most?
In Canada?
Okay.
Okay.
Greece or Canada? Like, why? Well, you know, we have a big catalog and they're all hits. No, I think if you ask every guy here, we all have different favorite songs. For different reasons. I don't know if you guys want to say what you like.
You mean from the last album or basically
from all the
back catalog?
My favorite songs never played live. We keep them out of the set list.
Which one?
Like Waiting Still.
We played it once.
Oh, we did it.
What's your favorite song?
Definitely, I have a few. It's pretty hard to choose. I would say Live and Die by the Sword, Between Heaven and Hell, something like that. I have to pick 10 or something.
I enjoy playing a lot of the new stuff. It goes down well.
Yeah.
I mean, we've been doing it for a year now. We've been playing the new songs live for a year. We're not bored. We just still enjoy playing them, so that means something. But I enjoy playing the older stuff too.
Yeah. Find the Fury is a cool.
Yeah.
Because it has all this.
Yeah.
It's a heavy thing.
It's very moving.
Oh, yes. And also, I like playing Tyranny because then it's like all this tension of the soul goes away and it's like a big part of the stage.
For me, Into the Fire from Old School Band.
More Major Songs. Okay.
Well, thanks. Yeah. Okay, amigo.
Yeah. Quería preguntarle personalmente si Firewind es la banda donde más ha explotado su técnica. Si es esta la banda, o bueno, personalmente yo pienso que sí, pero me gustaría preguntar.
He's asking, he also asked you personally, do you think Firewind is the band where you are?
Express
his technique more. Yeah.
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, it's been my little baby since I was a baby. Since I was 18 years old, so it's the band since I was 18 years old. It means a lot to me. So I certainly, yeah. I mean, lately I've been doing solo records because I have other sides that I want to, other things that I want to express in music. Still within the heavy metal genre, but Firewind has only been my main driving force. It was pretty clear from the beginning with Firewind, even in the early days when it was just a project around myself. It was just about to write my metal songs, and it kind of evolved from there. And you know, when members kept coming and going, everybody brought in their input, and that's also what made Firewind what it is today. But there's a certain code, unwritten or unset code in the band that everybody knows. That's kind of like my main output for doing the music. And the guys, they're like, how should I say? Like, they're all like kind of like satellites that add their own thing to the sound. And in the end, that's what makes Firewind what it is. That's why I think that band is so special. Yes?
Are you gonna play Mania next summer? Many people in Mexico hear that song in metal version. Are you gonna play Mania?
Think so. Fuck no. Maybe. No, I don't think so. We haven't rehearsed it in years. It's funny because that's not. No, it's not. That's our like our most popular song on Spotify.
Yeah.
I know he would like to play. There's a lot of keyboard stuff.
Yeah, it's funny.
Yeah, it's, yeah. Let's not start a separate discussion now. Yes.
For all, which has been the best moment of your career and why?
For us, you mean? For the band?
For the band.
We've had a lot of good moments in this band, like everybody, you know, you have like your ups and downs, and a lot of good things have happened to us over the years. I mean, I think one of the highlights is our first trip to Japan, or like the first time we went to America, our first American tour, or you know, when we had a number one record in our country, or like
Download Festival.
We were like the first band from Greece to play really big festivals in Europe. So we have a lot of things that we feel with, you know.
But also this period is really good.
Yeah, we're also,
we are here now, finally.
Yeah. I hope we will be remembered as a highlight.
I would like to ask, I know that it may be a surprise, but are you going to play a special song that we love? It's called Hate World Hero, and the other one is The Feast of Savages, specifically as well with Marty Friedman.
Same topic.
Are we going to have that kind of
surprise? Marty is not here, so
thank you. Actually, the only song we played from that album is Tyranny, and sometimes we play Choose to Live, but we haven't done Hate World Hero.